الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. وقال عز وجل: إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد الفاتح لما أغلق والخاتم لما سبق، ناصر الحق بالحق والهادي إلى صراطك المستقيم، وعلى آله حق قدره ومقداره العظيم، آمين. أما بعد، we begin in the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We begin by praising Him, by glorifying Him, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to shower His peace and blessings upon our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to send His mercy and forgiveness upon everyone in this gathering. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make this a source of guidance, a source of peace, a source of comfort in our dunya and akhirah. Ameen. Alhamdulillah, alhamdulillah, alhamdulillah. One of the things about being alive, being in this world, is that existence itself is a miracle that most people don't think about. The fact that you exist, this is something profound. The fact that you have wujud, that you have a being, this is something already profound. And this is, you know, because it's everywhere and you see it all around you, you're in that reality. Sometimes it escapes our awareness. There's an example one of my teachers gave me. Said two young fish were swimming by an older fish, and the older fish asked the younger fish, "How's the water?" And the younger fish, they looked at each other and they said, "What is water?" Right? They don't understand. They are in that reality. And this being alive, being in existence, having presence, this is a gift from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we are here to proclaim that all of life, all of existence, it all stems from the oneness of Allah. The power of Allah, al-hayyu al-qayyum, the source of all life, the giver of life, the one who sustains all life, this is Allah. That life that's flowing through you right now. We know before we are different life forms, we have that life force that's flowing through each and every one of us. Primordial life, when you go in deep into it, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, "Ya ayyuhan nas, O human beings, inna khalaqnakum min nafsin wahida." I created all of you from one soul. That one life, this is all of humanity. Allah says, "I created you all from that one soul. And from that I created its pair, and from those I created many men and many women." So have taqwa of Allah. Be conscious of Allah. When you look at one another, when you look at your brothers, you know, the first thing should not be their form, where they're from, what they're doing, what they're wearing, you know, what they look like. The first thing that should strike is, subhanAllah, this person is alive. And I am alive, and I can see that. And when you dive into that, there's some openings that comes with it. And so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He gave us this life. And while you're in this life, the experience of this world is many, many different things. Sometimes people experience amazing things that elates you, that gives you pleasure. You know, you see your children go to sleep at night, and you come home and you watch them, and then they're peaceful, sleeping. You can see, hear their breathing. You know, subhanAllah, this is something amazing. Right? And you see them grow day by day by day, learning new characteristics, new traits. Or you see your parents as they're aging, and they used to be able to do these great things, and now they're becoming dependent, and their health is now deteriorating. And you see all around you, the world, how it's changing all the time. And subhanAllah, when you dive into that, and you see the power of Allah, the one that sustains this whole thing, the one who manifests His attributes, His names in this creation, you look at it and you say, subhanAllah. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, "O human being, I sent you here to be tested." All of these things in front of you, this is all just a test. It's a sample of another reality. It's a sample of a greater reality. And so all the wonders that you see, all the beauty that you see, the seed that splits open, that comes out of the ground, that starts reaching towards the sky and starts looking at the light and says, "I want to be closer to that light." It spreads its wings, spreads its leaves. You know, you see that tree that grows and becomes firm, deeply rooted. And you see all of these wonders, all of these beauties. You see the birds, you know, singing, fajr time. praises of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You see the rivers coming down from the mountains. You see the sun rising and then it sets and then rises and then it sets. This amazing order in this creation. You see all of that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says all of this is nothing but the lowest reality. لَقَدْ زَيَّنَّا السَّمَاءَ الدُّنْيَا بِمَصَابِيحَ. He says this lowest dunya, the sky of the dunya, I decorated it with stars. You look up in the night sky. Now you have a lot of light pollution. Right, fake light that we emit from things that completely blocks out the divine things that Allah has placed in the skies for our guidance. So you look up at the night sky, if you go to the desert or sometimes when there's a power outage and we lose our artificial fake light, you look up and you see the wonders that Allah has placed in the heavens. Allah says all of this is sama'ud dunya. This is the sky of the lowest heaven. The lowest reality. Dunya comes from adna, something that is low. And here you are, oh human beings, in this dunya, going through the experiences of this dunya, just so you can have a taste, a sample of a greater reality. And you have to choose which reality do you want, because you know, you see that peace, that harmony, that moment of elation, that moment of pleasure, that moment of happiness, when you look at your family. When you look at those that you love, when you have that flow in your home, everything makes sense. Everything is going as it's supposed to. You say, subhanallah, right? I want that. Multiplied by eternity, multiplied by infinity. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, that is possible. That is a reality that I have prepared. Jannatul Firdaus, the gardens with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, beneath which rivers flow. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was asked, Ya Rasulullah, describe it to us. What is in Jannah? Describe it to us. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam did his best to describe. You and we live in three-dimensional world, right? You have up, down, left, right, you know, so all of our experiences is limited to that. You cannot describe certain colors, you know, or anything to do with colors to a blind person who's never seen color. That's beyond their frame of reference. And so the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam attempted to describe what is Jannah like. And finally, he said, you know, in it there are things no eye has ever seen, no ear has ever heard, no mind can ever comprehend, no heart can ever imagine. Right? This is the reality that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is proposing. He's putting in front of you, choose. Right? And then the other extreme, sometimes you have pain, sometimes you have suffering, sometimes you have hardship, sometimes you have miserable experiences, sometimes you wish that everything would stop. That you just find a place and just go lay down, that's it. You know, life is getting difficult. How do you deal with this and this and this and this? All of these problems come one on top of the other and you wonder, can it get any worse? Can it get any worse? And this is also part of this world. This is also part of this reality. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put it here by design. You have a problem? You know, one of my teachers said, whenever you ask the question, why is Allah doing this? Why is Allah doing that? You know what? This is Allah's creation. He can do whatever He wants. When you go make your own planet, do what you like. But while you're in the creation of Allah, and you are the creation of Allah, don't ask why to Allah. Allah, He does what He wants. فَعَالٌ لِمَا يُرِيدٌ. But you will be asked. And so, when you have these difficult things come to you, loss of a loved one, you know, the person goes to the doctor and, you know, just normal checkup, and the doctor says, I'm sorry, you have been diagnosed with stage 4 cancer. You only have a couple months to live. That person's whole life is now shook. Right? What do I do now? I'm going to die in two years, 2 months, 3 months. What's going to happen to this? What's going to happen to my family? My kids are still young. Everything now starts turn upside down. What do you do in that situation? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, oh human beings, Alif Lam Mim. أحسب الناس أن يتركوا أن يقولوا آمنا وهم لا يفتنون. Oh human beings, did you really think you're going to walk around saying I believe in Allah, I believe in Allah, and Allah's not going to test you? Did you really think that the test will not come to you? Definitely those that went before you, they were tested with more severe tests than you. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he was sitting when Sahabi approached him, said, Ya Rasulullah, make dua that this persecution end. Make dua that these people stop torturing us, that they stop doing this to us, that they stop doing that to us. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, his face turned red with anger. He said, you people are in a hurry. You want to rush things. Allah has a plan. Let his plan take its time. Let his plan roll out the way he wants. You're in a hurry. And the people asked the Sahabi, said, what were you complaining about? He lifted up his shirt and that was enough. The Quraysh would tie him up and they would put burning charcoals on the back of his flesh, burning holes in his meat, in his muscles. And the Prophet ﷺ told them, be patient, you're in a rush, you're in a hurry. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has promised. Is his promise not enough? وَالْعَاقَبَةُ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. The eventual outcome is for the muttaqeen. So be amongst the muttaqeen. This is what you're supposed to do. Work on yourself, work on your taqwa, work on your deen, work on these things. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He takes from our ummah, shuhada. He takes from our ummah, people that are witnesses for Him. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us, this is, my ummah is the ummah that has Allah's mercy on it. And Allah takes from us the shuhada, the people that will come on the day of judgment, they have top 100 levels of Jannah. And many people, they don't know how to process the tragedies that happen in their life, the tragedies that happen in the world, they cannot process it. The reality is, everything is in the hands of Allah. Allah never lost control of the creation. Allah has been in charge, Allah is in charge, Allah will be in charge. Everything is in His hands. You want justice? You want justice, fairness? You're not going to find it in this world. Justice, fairness, you will see on the day of judgment, Allah will equal the field. Allah will bring everything to balance. But right now it's a test. When you say, I believe in Allah, I believe in the day of judgment, what does that mean? You believe in the day of judgment. Sometimes we cannot stand a small discomfort from our co-worker or from our relative or from our in-laws or our sons or daughters or parents. Small little thing. They will say it's heavy for us. And we want to break and tie, cut off our ties of kinship. What about the day of judgment? When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says people will come. And on that day, even those that were close like this, father will say, take my children, throw them into the fire, just save me. Mother will say, throw my children into the fire, save me. People will cut off all their ties and they'll look at hellfire and say, Ya Allah, take everything, just save me. You have a choice now. Save yourself, save your families. You know, and don't give in to despair. Don't give in to fear. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, they're afraid of people. You're afraid of people. Allah is more deserving to be feared. You're afraid of people. Allah is more deserving to be feared. And our scholars said, you know, sometimes we teach Islam and we talk about the fear of Allah and then the adab and all these other things. What is this about? Really, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was sent as Nadir and Bashir. Bashir is the giver of glad tidings, and Nadir is the one who gives warning. And really, the glad tidings were for people who pray. People who come to the masajid. People who do good things in their life. For us, this is what the Prophet ﷺ's role was. He came to give you bishara. A lot of people here, despite the news, what's being spread. This is a sign of iman. That you value your iman more than what these other people are running away from. And those who escape death, it's going to find you wherever you go. You put yourself in a panic room, lock all the doors, close everything, death is still going to come. So there's no escaping from that reality. The time of death is written. Everything is written. Now how it happens, when it happens, by whose hands it happens, this is Allah, He's going to deal with them on the day of judgment. But for you, glad tidings. You're here, you're the people of Allah. You've left your works, you've left your businesses, you've left your jobs to come here to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You are the people of Allah. And glad tidings to you. And the Nadir, the one who gives warning, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he was sent to give warning to those who are not engaged in the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Who are causing corruption in the land, who are spreading corruption in the land, who are killing people. And so, you know, this is the reality of our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He was sent as a mercy. And he was sent to give you glad tidings. And so take the glad tidings. Alhamdulillah. Say Alhamdulillah. And may I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive our shortcomings, to forgive our sins, to forgive our mistakes. أَقُولِ قَوْلِ هَذَا أَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لَكُمْ فَاسْتَغْفِرُوهُ إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen, Salatu wa Salaam ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala Sahbih Ajma'in. And so we have to really wonder about what is this life about. If you don't have that big perspective, that big picture, every small bump on the road is going to throw you off course. Every bump on the road is going to make you lose your way. And sometimes the fitan, they come one after the other. The Prophet ﷺ, he described one of the signs of the end of time. He said, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the fitnas will come one after the other, like a darkness of the night that's covered by more darkness. And the Sahaba asked, what's the refuge, Ya Rasulullah? Where do we turn to? He said, turn to the Book of Allah. Turn, if you need comfort, you need to calm your heart down, go to the Book of Allah. Look at what Allah says. Look at what Allah is describing. Because when you really have that big perspective, you see that big picture. Okay, I have a problem today. I have another problem tomorrow. And this is happening. The news says this, that's going on, this is going on. What's happening in the world? Right? All this confusion, everything's going on. And so what happens? You turn to the Book of Allah, you find, wait a second, there's a meeting with Allah. I'm going to go stand in front of Him. You know, I have bigger things to worry about. What am I going to say to Allah about the way I conducted myself? What am I going to say to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? When I saw this building burning down and I had water and I didn't put anything out, I just stood by and watched everything burn down, what am I going to say? Right? If you can do something, do something. If you can't do anything, make dua. Right? But do something. You know, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, if you see something wrong, fix it with your hands. If you can't fix it with your hand, speak out against it. If you can't speak out against it, then don't like it in your heart. Reject it in your heart. You know, what can you do? Stop letting your kids play video games that shoot people, kill people. This is, how do they learn these things? Where are they getting this stuff from? This is, we're being systematically taught how to kill, how to murder. And you wonder, why is there so much violence in the world? We are teaching it and we're allowing it. Do something about it. Right? You have children, you're raising them, you want to be compassionate people? Teach them compassion. Teach them mercy. You want them to be knowledgeable people? Educate them. Right? The Prophet ﷺ said, Al-ilm bit-ta'allum. Knowledge is with teaching. Wal-hilm bit-tahallum. And compassion is learned by mercy. You show them mercy. And you know, we have to really analyze what's going on and wonder, right? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I'm going to meet Him, I'm going to talk to Him, and He's going to ask me, you were in this time, you lived in this world, you saw what happened, okay, what choices did you make? Because you were given a sample of everything. You saw what pleasure is, you saw what pain is, what did you choose? You saw what being a muslih means, someone who fixes things. You saw what mufsid means, someone who breaks things. Which one did you choose to be? And so we have a choice. And as Muslims, we're not just, you know, people that stand by. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, كُنْتُمْ خَيْرَ أُمَّةٍ أُخْرِجَتْ لِلنَّاسِ. You're the best nation that was raised up for mankind. And why? Because you encourage the good and you forbid the evil. Doesn't mean go out and do things like violently. No. Systematically, in a beautiful way, in a constructive way. Go and do, make a difference in the world. Have an impact in the world. Be great people. Right? And then what happens? You, and also your shuhada al-nas, your witnesses over mankind. You see what's going on in the world. Whatever effect you can have, whatever influence you can have, you did. And whatever is beyond you, you come on the Day of Judgment as witnesses. Ya Allah, we did our job. And I'm a witness, I testify, these people, they did this. And you know who's the witness for us or against us? The Quran and the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He mentions in the Quran that the Day of Judgment happens, the people are brought forth, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala calls the messenger to testify on behalf of the ummah. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gives his testimony. You know what he says? You know what he says? Ya Allah, my people, they took the Quran as something abandoned. They left it. They was in the shelves, collected dust. They didn't go to it for guidance. They didn't look at it for anything. They just did whatever they wanted to do. And now they want to be, you know, amongst the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he complains to us that we didn't take the Quran seriously. What is the Quran going to say? What's the Quran going to say on the Day of Judgment? Right? And so we have a choice. You can live your life based on the teachings and the guidance of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, or you can do what you want. And you see the confusion in the world. If you don't have that light that guides you, What are we going to do? And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to increase that light in all of us. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to shower us with His mercy, to forgive our sins. Ya Allah, Ya Rahman, Ya Rahim, those that passed away yesterday, Ya Rabbal Alameen, we ask You to grant them Your mercy, Ya Allah. Grant their families sabr, Ya Allah. We ask Ya Rabbal Alameen, those of them that are injured, Ya Rabbal Alameen, we ask them to grant them complete recovery, Ya Allah. Ya Rahman, Rahimin, we ask You to protect all the Muslims all over the world, Ya Allah. We ask Ya Rabbal Alameen, grant us peace, Ya Allah. We ask Ya Rabbal Alameen, grant us tranquility, Ya Allah. We ask Ya Rabbal Alameen, grant us security after our fear, Ya Allah. We ask You, Ya Allah, Ya Rahman, Ya Rahim, all the people that are suffering, Ya Allah, that are under oppressive regimes, Ya Allah, that are going through occupation and other things, Ya Rabbal Alameen, we ask You to grant us victory, Ya Allah. Grant us nasr, Ya Allah. Your promise is true, Ya Allah. Ya Arhamar Rahimin, and we ask You to make us people deserving of victory, Ya Allah. Make us people of taqwa, Ya Allah. And we ask Ya Rabbal Alameen to elevate us to high level, Ya Allah. And don't make us oppressors over those that oppressed us, Ya Allah. Ya Rahman, Ya Rahim, we ask You to grant us in our hearts an opening of mercy and compassion, Ya Allah. And allow us to represent our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the best manner, Ya Allah. Wa sallallahu ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Aqimu s-salah.
الله أكبر.